Hey guys, I'm sorry I look like shit because I've been up a lot with the market crashing and of course a new baby I have and my two girlfriends. It all comes together and that's why. But the markets have crashed a lot and I think we reached the bottom. Yes, yes, yes. I seem to be the only one calling a bottom here. That's interesting to note. But yeah, 4,400 was the low when I called to the bottom, but that broke already a couple of minutes later. And it went down to 4,000 yesterday. That was the actual bottom. And for Bitcoin Cash, I called the bottom at 210 and that was the bottom up until now. I'm sorry, I'm not really following Ethereum anymore because I decided not to buy it. But I think just for the general market that we saw a bottom yesterday. But of course, some coins, well, actually, there is a probability here too. Like, I think the probability for Bitcoin Cash is the highest that it found a bottom. Because it dropped almost 50% yesterday, and that was crazy. And it reached a $200 target that I had set also in advance. That would be a 95% correction, and so that happened. So I bought extremely strong. I went from an allocation of about 25% crypto to about 70% crypto, and I plan to go to 100%. Why? So, because the Trololo chart, yesterday the low was about 140 billion, and that's about 45% below the trend line that was yesterday at 245 billion. So, that's the first serious undervaluation that we see here. In previous bear markets, this was also the low in fiat valuations. The first serious undervaluation. That was the case in the bear market of 2011 and bear market of 2014. In 2014, it was a drop of about $300 US or 350, 300 to a low of $160 US for Bitcoin. And then suddenly you had an undervaluation. Check the Trololo chart on my previous videos, you can see it there. I made one video, when will the crypto bottom be, a month ago, where I show that. Start watching in the middle. I said also in that video that the rational thing to do is to go to a majority crypto allocation, but I am actually considering to go 100% invested already at that point. Why? Because that's the fiat bottom, most likely. It's true that there are some like red flags here. For example, the timing is off. It should be only by the middle of 2019 that we see the bottom. That's a problem. The volume is too low. Then usually a bottom is reached with high volume, and I haven't studied volume. I never study volume, but from the tweets I've seen, it looks like the volume is also not there yet. So these are some red flags that indicate that it could be wrong, and that actually the probability for this to be a bottom is not so high. But it all depends on what do you give the most weight, huh? And I personally give the most weight to the Trololo chart, and there and some other stuff too, like Owl and Wonder. It also works on a similar chart, logarithmic regression, and he also in advance made a prediction just based on mathematical calculations that the low for Bitcoin should be around $4,800 US to have a similar drawdown compared to its rise in the previous bull market, and then comparing to the previous cycles, that should be the low, and it went considerably lower. So actually the correction was compared to the bull market that we had for Bitcoin already stronger than in previous corrections. And so I that's also interesting. So I raised my bottom target of 3,000 for Bitcoin, because many say it will be 3,000, but based on what? What calculation did they make? Never see a calculation. It should be a rational, like, how do you get to that number? It's just like 3,000. Owen Wonder, his Twitter, check his account. I also, or check my account, I retweet a lot of stuff about him. He made the exact calculation, and that's the number, that's based on exact calculation, that number 4,800. So, and you can't expect bear markets to become stronger over time. No. So, another indicator that convinces me that we saw the bottom here is the market sentiment. Everybody's calling prices to go lower. Suddenly, nobody talks about the bottom anymore. Before it was, yeah, that's the bottom. Is this the bottom? Is this the bottom? Nobody's asking me if it's the bottom today. And interesting, Louis Thomas made a video on YouTube saying that he bought Bitcoin. And you look at the responses, and there are nice people that say congratulations, but for the most part, and there are a few comments that say, like, they think that's smart, but the majority of the comments is that that's not smart and it probably will go lower. This is new in this bear market, never happened before, that the majority called for lower prices. So I think that's also interesting. It means that even if this is not the bottom, it is already a good buy. Also based on Trollo chart, if you're 45% below, or 40% below fair valuation in crypto, that's a great deal. Now, if you've seen my previous Trollo videos, then you see that actually it's expect to go to an undervaluation of minus 80% or so in this bear market, but that's still valid. But of course, that doesn't mean lower fiat prices, because in the meantime the trend line goes up and up and up. And if you look at what's happening here, well, it seems the bottom is way too soon here. So what could happen? A possible scenario here is that it is indeed too soon, but it is what's happened, and so from here we get that slow year, but we don't get one slow year, we get two slow years of rebuilding, and so like basically sideways movements that go a little bit up, but very slow, and so at least two more strong corrections that reach these lows that we've seen today, but not fully. They are higher, and in the meantime, the trend line continues to go up a lot. And in 1 year time, we're at 800 billion. In 2 year time, we're at 1 trillion expected market valuation, or maybe 1.2 trillion, something like that. Or maybe even 1.5 trillion. And in the meantime, markets have still been going sideways from the current 150 billion market cap to maybe by that time 300 billion. But that's indeed 80% below fair valuation, so it could double in 2 years time from here and still be like at an 80% undervaluation. So I think this is the most likely scenario here. But I have to admit, like, I'm not confident in Bitcoin. I have not bought Bitcoin. I only buy Bitcoin Cash. There I'm really confident that actually I think it's very probable. I would say give it like 80% probability that we saw the low here, because Bitcoin Cash really made a much bigger dive than the other ones due to all the drama. The coin basically split in two, and a piece of the community went away, the SV part, and so they many of them sold their BCH coins, dumped them, and but it's of course, for the most part, just a general investor that was investing in Bitcoin Cash during the bull market and then sees all the drama and says, fuck this shit, I'm out. You didn't have this in Ethereum or in Ripple or in Bitcoin. All is well there. And so that's why the price didn't go so deep as with Bitcoin Cash. But that's, of course, opportunity. So I think that even if I'm wrong and the bottom does happen and it ends up being 3,000 in 1.5 year time, well, for Bitcoin Cash, it could actually be then still not going to go below 200. Because what basically happened in 1 or 2 days time was that the price of Bitcoin Cash dropped from $400 above $400, which was the strong support line for the bear market. During the split of the past week, it dropped to $200. I could buy it more than two. I've never been right about calling the bottom correctly. I was too soon in the previous bear market of 2014. I thought the bottom was reached around $300, and then a month later it cuts in half again. But what I did then was gradually moving in, and I ended up choosing for an exposure when it was then dropped from $260, was back at $200. I chose an exposure about 80%, and I left about 20% in fiat and other stuff. And that I don't want to repeat. I don't want to have a remaining 20% not invested in crypto. That's why I probably will go full retort on this one and go for an 100% allocation. So, a little bit more about, is this wise? Because if you look at it scientifically, that's not wise. You should never invest 100% into something. And so why take such risks? As an investor, I've talked a lot about the Kelly criterion in the past. You look at your probabilities of winning, the risk-reward ratio, and you invest the most in the best risk-reward ratio. But you can, even if the risk-reward ratio is amazing and very high, then still there is a low probability. Just going to go out of sun here. A low probability of failure. And that's the case now too. But I think that investing is a continuous process. It's not you don't make a decision in one day and then you stop making decisions till the investment has panned out or not. It doesn't work that way. You can every day reevaluate the risk reward ratio of an investment, and if it turns sour, decide to get out. And that's what I, of course, plan to do if Bitcoin Cash goes the wrong way. But I think for now it looks very good. I think that something like Bitcoin Cash, it's unbelievable that it sells at $200. This is a price lower than when it was launched in August of 2017 and forked off Bitcoin Core. The price was $300. It was 1/10 of the Bitcoin price, which was then $3,000. And right now, it's actually not 1/10, but 1/20. So it's cut in half versus Bitcoin, and versus fiat is even lower than then. But so much has happened since Bitcoin Cash was launched. It has grown a lot in adoption. Maybe has it 1,000-folded or even more in the amount of merchants that use it. Compared to then its first weeks of existence. I don't know the numbers, just guessing here, but massive growth, also in amount of transactions. I don't have them by head, but the growth in amount of transactions is very good for Bitcoin Cash, even if you exclude all the tests, transactions. It's really growing fast compared to, for example, Bitcoin, Litecoin just collapsing in amount of transactions. It's growing like the way Ethereum does. This is also like the leader in amount of transactions. But Bitcoin Cash grows at the same growth rate as Ethereum. So that's a great performance. And of course, that's in the end what counts, real adoption. So I feel very confident. Also, the market cap of Bitcoin Cash is $3 billion. is the same as number 4th, 5th, 6th, I guess, Stellar and some other projects nobody knows or very infamous. Well, they are about the same value as Bitcoin Cash. Bitcoin Cash is still on the 4th place, but it could drop lower since it's very close now to other market caps. And 3 billion, I think, is a very low valuation for what it is. This is a coin that has a good chance of dethroning Bitcoin in the next bull run. I really believe that that is actually a good probability here. Bitcoin was again a total hell in this little market meltdown. You send Bitcoin, it gets stuck somewhere for a half a day, right? Or a day, right? When you need the Bitcoin, of course. So Bitcoin is just shit to transfer value. You can't count on it. And exchanges can't count on it neither. So all these customers come complaining, hey, where is my Bitcoins? Oh, sorry, it's stuck in the network. They didn't pay enough transaction fee. But who knows how much you need to pay? And to stay on top of all that when it constantly changes. It's just a very poor cryptocurrency solution. So I think Bitcoin Cash makes a very good chance to beat Bitcoin in the future. But first it will go via speculation. It's speculators, investors like us that will bid up the price higher than Bitcoin. I think will happen in the next bull run, but towards the end of the bull run. And I do think that Ethereum will be the first one to become bigger as Bitcoin. But after that, I think Bitcoin Cash will do the same. This is the potential here. It's tremendous. And I think also with the whole, I'm happy with the conflict that happened because it gave a great opportunity to buy Bitcoin Cash cheap, and still today it's only $250. But especially I'm very happy to see these people go out of the Bitcoin Cash community. I really don't like maximalists and maximalist thinking, and I think it's really not inviting for people to join a community or a coin where people are extremist thinkers and are intolerant of other people and other people's projects and talk negative about other people's projects but unjustifiably so. Like, fair critiques is good, but if you start to spread FUD, so you're gonna start say lies about other people or other projects, untruths, just to scare people away from these projects, that's just nasty behavior, and I'm not gonna really, like, I don't want that in my life, and I don't want to invest in projects that have a majority of such people in, like Monero, for example, who continuously does that to his other projects, for the most part. Of course, you will have also great Monero supporters, but many Monero supporters do that, and so I think that's poisonous behavior. And in Bitcoin you have that also, maximalists, but in Bitcoin Cash you also had it. So I'm happy this conflict happened because many of them went out with Craig Wright. So for me that's a nice cleanup. I don't know all the technical details of the conflict. I'm an investor. I know something about finances, investing, and maybe also dating, but I'm not a programmer, and so many of the technical discussions about why SV is better than ABC, I can't follow, I can't judge, but I'm a good judger in persons and peoples, and I don't really need to understand technical things they are explaining. I can see the way they act and talk, and whether they are honorable people or not. And I cannot say that of Craig Wright, and also not of Calvin Ayer, who are leading SV. By accident I met some developers on the Endchain on some conference, and it was just an awkward cold conversation. It was weird. So these things do stand out for me. I think that was it. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. I think whatever crypto you believe in, I think it's a good idea to build up your position if you're lowly exposure at current prices. But it's fair to say there is no rush here. It will be a sideways movement, extremely likely. This is not going to go into a bull market anytime soon. But one last thing, why did I go 100% into, well, or plan to go 100% into crypto? It's because I want to live that way, and I really want to start spending cryptocurrency and just other investments. Just take energy from me and are a waste of opportunity in the long run. And just take away my focus. There's only so much energy I have in a day, especially now that I'm starting family. And so I want to keep life simple, and that means reduce my investments to a few cryptocurrencies. I still have Byteball, but I'm not planning to buy that now. I'm planning to buy Byteball in 1 year's time or so after the sideways movement has happened. And I think in the meantime, Bitcoin Cash will go up a lot versus Byteball, and then I'll probably maybe double or triple my position. And the same for the other coin I hold, Bismuth. But I don't want many cryptocurrencies, and I want to keep it simple. And I just want to like start helping the crypto economy by start spending Bitcoin Cash, and later maybe focus also on Byteball, and become more active. And I've been saying this for years, it doesn't never seem to happen, but it's because I've always been focused on the price also, and I really started to do this very well, predicting price movements. But I really want to start doing something else. I really believe that the strategy to buy and hold is the best one, even if you're good at predicting price movements, then still, but only if you enter when the bear market is finished, and the bull market starts, and then you enter and you go like a very large allocation and just buy and hold, and you don't try to exit, that's the best movement, because basically what you will get is an 100x, and then the correction comes and you get a correction of cut by 10, but that's still 10x from here, and you don't have to do anything but buy and hold. In the meantime, it will go 100x, you didn't sell anything, okay, but you still have 10x after it's all finished, and investors can't show such returns. If you try to time market, you will never show such a return. Yes, you can, but it's very, very rare. For the most part, you're failing. And still, like even if you can show such returns, because you've been very busy with the price, and so have been really trading, and that's what you do. Are you really helping the currency that much that way? I think I can do a lot more to help the currency. Roger Verstappen, by really spending it, building your life around it, promoting it. I think I can build a lot more value there than trying to buy low and sell high. I'm going to leave that to other people. So I really plan to hold these currencies that I bought now forever. And don't plan to, it's going well, sell them for other cryptos, yes. And of course also spend them. And I do plan to spend a lot if there would be a new bubble then. And my holdings go up a lot in value. I will try to spend it on fancy and fun stuff. That's my plan with that. So that's why I really want to go this 100% in, so that I don't have to this, because I also lost so much opportunity in previous bull markets by hedging, keeping some money on the sideline, and then as market go up, building up that fiat stash. Or other things that have value outside of crypto, like that Lambo, for example. I bought that as with the idea, like, can't put it all in crypto, so let's buy a fun toy too. But if you look at the missed opportunity, that's just tremendous. Like, the money I put in that Lambo would have, like, at least 10-fold or more, 20-fold or if I wouldn't have put it in there, and that's all lost opportunity. I think renting makes a lot more sense, especially if you want to spend crypto. You can dictate the terms. You want to spend rent a fancy Lambo, but you only want to pay Bitcoin Cash. You will surely find someone. That's not a problem. And so it gives you much more flexibility. You lose a lot less opportunity cost. By just having the attitude to rent cars, to rent apartments or real estate, to rent holiday houses, like all these things you can rent. You don't need to buy that to diversify. And you can really help the crypto economy if you use your crypto coins for it. So that's my plan. I hope you guys enjoyed it. And I wish you all good luck with whatever coin is close and dear to your heart. Bye.